If you feel these videos are useful and you like it, please like and share these videos and subscribe to our channel and press the notification symbol and opt for the option All among the three options in the notification symbol so that all the videos will be notified as soon as uploaded in the channel. Thank you. Now, let's get back to the video.
Hi friends! In this video, let's learn how to code a soccer game in Scratch. First, we must use a sprite for our project. Let us pick the cat first. Then, let us pick a green button, a soccer ball, and a cross sign. Now, let us use a backdrop. Since we are making a soccer game, let us choose a soccer field in sports. Now position them. The ball will come from the green button to the cross. So we will put them at opposite ends near to the goalpost. First, let's program the cat. Select the cat's image in the sprite menu. A blue outline will appear over its box. Now let's program it. First, go to the control section and take the forever block. Then go to the event section and select when flag click block and put it above the forever block. Now go to the motion section and select the go to block. In the options, change it to mouse pointer. Place it inside the forever block. Wow! Look at the screen. You can see the cat moving with the mouse. We are done programming the first sprite. Now let us start programming the soccer ball. Select it from the sprite menu. Let's code the ball. Go to the control section and select the forever block and the if then block. Place the if then block into the forever block. Now go to the motion section and select the move 10 steps and if on edge bounce blocks and place them above the if then block. Then go to the sensing section and select the touching edge block and place it between if and then in the hexagon. Then go to the sound section and select the play sound until done block. The sound must be a basketball bounce and place it in the if then block. Then go to the motion section. Select the point towards turn right and move 10 steps block. Place them all inside the if then block. Change the degrees from 15 to 180. Go to event section and place the when flag click block over this code. One part of the code for the ball is done now. Let's do the second part now. Go to the variables section and select the set variable to block. Change the variable name to score by making a variable and ticking it under make a variable option. Let the value of the score be 0. Now go to the motion section and select the go to x block. Change x value to 194 and y value to 17. Now take a forever block from the control section and put a move 10 steps block in it. Then take an if then block and place it inside the forever block. Between it, put a touching block and change its option to button 1. Now put a play sound until done block inside the if then block. Go to sounds and add a rattle sound. Now take take a change by block from variable section. Change my variable to score and let its value be 1. Now go to control and take a wait 1 second block and put it after change score block. Now go to motion and take a go to block. Change x to 194 and y to 17. This value is the position of the green button. Go to event section and place the when flag click block over this code. Also, change the point towards block's mouse pointer to cat. Change the touching edge block's option to mouse pointer. The code is finally done. Come on. Now let us check if our code is working. With a bouncing sound, the ball must go from the button to the cross and the cat must know it will bounce with the mouse pointer. If the ball touches the cat and go back to the green button with a rattle sound, this means your code is correct and the game is ready to be played. Enjoy playing, friends! And stay safe. See you all soon in another useful video. Take care. Bye-bye. Till then, it's bye from Bhadresh and Srinivasan. Thank you.